this summary which you have seen, I will summarize the whatever you have written in terms of sentences here more pictorially. So, we began with a plane and then whose normal was n, and we had a stress vector acting on that plane, and we introduce a coordinate system associated with the plane, normal to the plane, and then the two directions on the surface of the plane. Then we resolved stress vector acting on this plane along these three directions, and those are tau nn, tau ns1, tau ns2, and represented vectorially here. That is where we started. Any plane, stress vector acting on this plane and resolved along the coordinate axis attached to the plane, namely ns1, s2. And this is the normal stress, and these two together are the shear stresses. Now, next what we did, remember same plane, same stress vector, but now our coordinate axes are x, y and then z, very well known coordinate axis. Resolve the same stress vector, same plane, same point, remember mean the plane shown there is exaggerated. You should imagine a very, very small plane, because remember stress vector is at a point, at a point. And now that stress vector has now been resolved along x axis, y axis and z axis, represented vectorially here. The stress vector, same stress vector, now the unit vectors are I, j and then k, components are tau n, n is same, second subscript has changed to x, tau n y, tau n z. That was the second stage. Now, the third stage, okay. Look at the figure, the slides have been made so that at the same location we replace with three planes. Let me go back and come back so that you have a clear understanding. At the same point we have some arbitrary plane of any direction n vector. Instead of my objective is finally to find out the stress vector and then these components, because on a plane I am interested what is the normal force, what are the tangential forces, that is my objective. Because that is straight away difficult, we resolved along x, y, z axis. Because this is also straight away difficult, we said I will consider three planes at the same position. This white is just a background, not the that inclined plane. Instead of this inclined plane or any plane, at the same point I consider three well defined planes. When I say well defined, those planes are parallel to our usual x, y, z coordinate planes, which we denote as x plane, y plane, z plane. So, now let us take the x plane. The x plane is shown by this yellow color, and that is what is shown magnified here. So, this is the x plane. Now, T x is a stress vector acting on this x plane, remember, that is T n is the stress vector act, the n plane is not shown in this diagram, T n is stress vector acting on the n plane, T x is the stress vector acting on the x plane shown here with its components tau xx, tau xy, tau xz. So, this is the normal stress acting on x plane, these are the shear stresses acting on the x plane, I think very clearly shown in terms of normal and then tangential directions. Vectorially you represent this way, T x as tau xxi, tau xyj, tau xzk. Now, similarly you take the y plane. The y plane is shown here, light shade of blue color, and then T y is a stress vector on the y plane, and then the components are tau y x, tau y y, tau y z, and shown vectorially here. Similarly, the z plane here, the z plane here, and shown by an orange color, and then the stress vector acting on that z plane, and what are the components, tau z x, tau z y, tau z z, and then shown vectorially here. We started with Tn, we have to find out that, but now we have come to Tx, Ty, Tz. How are we going to do that? We will see shortly. Now, once again I will summarize this in another way, I would say completely in the reverse direction. We went in one direction forward, Now, next slide will summarize the entire discussion in a reverse direction. Okay, let us see that. Now, what are the steps to calculate? If we know these 9 components, remember this is where we ended, we are starting from there. If we know these 9 components, this is where we ended, we are beginning from there. What are the 9 components? This tau xx, tau xy, tau xz, tau yx, tau yy, tau yz, similarly tau zx, zy, zz. Okay. So, if we know these 9 components, we can calculate these 3 components of stress vector, but these components of stress vector are along x, y and z axis. We get the components of stress vector, but the components are along x, y, z axis. How do we do that? We will discuss later. Suppose we are able to get these components, I can calculate these 3 components. What are these components? These are the components along the normal to the plane and tangential to the plane. This is what we are interested in. Finally, we need to calculate these 3 components, which are along n, s 1 and s 2 and tau n and tau n s 1 and tau n s 2. Okay. Now, second step is simple, that is pure mathematics. If you are having a vector resolved along x, y, z axis, then you can resolve easily along any other coordinate axis, that is the second step. Okay. So, if you know T n resolved along x, y, x, y and then z axis, you can resolve T n along n, s 1 and s 2 directions. Is that okay? We have resolved T n along I, j, k and we have resolved along n, s 1, s 2. Now, second step is easier, first step we will discuss later. Okay. Now, what we will do is collect all the components and put in a more structured way, and that is shown in the form of a pictorial representation here, that is what is shown on the left hand side. Let us first understand the axis, x axis, y axis and z axis. Okay. What is shown is a cuboidal shape. I want to emphasize that it is called stress element, it is not a physical volume, it is not a physical volume. We have seen control volumes earlier, this is not a control volume, this is only a representation of all the 9 components which are discussed earlier. Okay. So, once again to emphasize, this is just a pictorial representation, not a control volume, it is called a stress element. What does it, what is it being shown there? Okay. Let us take this face, the right hand side face, and its x phase because x axis is perpendicular to that, and you have a stress vector acting on this phase which is not shown, but what is shown are the components of Tx. Remember we discussed about stress vector acting on x plane, what is shown here are the components of the stress vector along x direction, y direction and z direction. So, the 3 components of stress vector acting on x plane are shown here. Similarly, take the top face, once again the stress vector Ty is not shown, but the components of that stress vector tau yx, tau yy, tau yz are shown there. Similarly, take the front face, a stress vector here you have Ty and let us say here you have Tz, that stress vector is not shown, but the components are shown here along x axis tau zx, tau zy and then tau zz. Okay. So, totally 9 components are shown, 3 components for Tx, 3 for Ty, 3 for Tz. Okay. And that is what is also summarized in this table, direction of normal to the plane x, y, z, we have considered planes whose normals are x, y, z, and then the direction of components are once again x, y, z, that is why we result in combination of 3 by 3. 9 components are there. Okay. So, if you look at the first row they are all components of Tx, whatever you see on the right side face, and then if you take the second row they are all components of the vector acting on the y plane, the top plane, and then if you look at the third row they are all components of stress vector acting on the front face. Okay. So, these 3 rows with 3 elements is can be represented as a matrix. Okay. The whatever represent the table, all the 9 components have been arranged in a form of a matrix. Now, I called as a matrix, but a more formal representation is called a tensor. Okay? Though the 9 components have been put in what is called as a stress tensor, as the title indicates. Now, if you look at the what is a stress tensor, you will gradually understand as you go along the course. As far as this course goes, we are not going to discuss in detail about tensors, but you will have a small introduction to that. You will slowly understand what tensors are as we go along. Okay. So, right now you can imagine as a matrix which has 9 elements in it, and remember each row represents the 3 components of the stress vectors, 3 stress vectors, and each row we are used to represent the 3 components of the stress vectors. Okay. Now, that is why we have 9 components here. Now, if you look at this diagram, there are 9 other components shown with dashed lines. If you look at the left face, some 3 components are shown. If you look at the bottom face, some 3 components are shown. If you look at the rear face, some 3 other components are shown. Okay. They are shown in opposite direction, and they are shown in dashed line. Okay. Now, to understand that, what are they? Let us look at the next slide. Now, for representing stress element, we follow a sign convention. What is the sign convention? Okay. Now, if you have a what is sign convention for a stress component? You consider a stress component of stress tensor to be positive under 2 conditions. What are the conditions? If we have a positive face, what is a positive face? You have a plane whose axis is towards the positive x axis. So, this is a positive face. In that positive face, if the direction of force is also along the positive axis, then this component is a positive value. That is, so if the direction of the normal to the plane is positive, and then the direction of the force is also positive, then the direction of stress component is positive. What is the other possibility? If the direction of the phase is negative, that is what is shown here. When I say negative direction, phase is negative, direction of the normal to the phase along the negative x axis, and the direction of the force is also negative, force is also negative, then once again you represent a positive component of the stress tensor. So, the right hand side representation and the left hand side representation are both equivalent, both equivalent. If you take a face whose normal is along positive x axis, all your arrow marks are along the positive coordinate direction. So, this component is along positive x axis, this component is along positive y axis, and this component is along positive z axis. Now, if you take the left hand side face, the normal to the plane is along negative x axis. Now, look at all the arrow marks, they are towards the negative axis, negative x axis, negative y axis, negative z axis, but both represent the same tau xx, the same tau xy, and then same tau xz. That is same, only it is like you have a plane, you are looking at opposite sides of the same plane. Remember, it is not a, as I told, it is not a control volume. This same plane you are looking from this side, same plane looking from the other side, okay, same equivalent representation. Similarly, for the what we had discussed earlier is for the top face, for the bottom face, the normal to the face along negative y axis. That is why all the directions of the force are also along negative axis. See, tau y x is along negative x axis, tau y along negative y axis, tau y z along negative z axis. Similarly, for the rear face, for the rear face, we have discussed earlier for the front face, for the rear face, the normal to the face is along negative z axis. So, all the direction of the force are also along negative axis, tau z x along negative x axis, tau z y along negative y axis, tau z z along negative. So, though 18 components are shown, but they are equivalent to just 9 components. Okay. Only 2 ways of representing it. Okay. Just want to discuss the other way also. If one of them is opposite direction, that is, if you have a positive face and the force is along negative direction, then the stress component is negative. Or if the direction of the normal to the face is along negative axis and the direction of the force is along a positive axis, then again you have a negative stress component. Okay. So, if both are positive or both are negative, you have positive. Any other combination gives you the negative value of stress component. I have an example to show you, you will understand better. Now, the question arises, why 18 are shown? Why is it shown as a something like a closed box? Okay. Explain that here. This diagram is same as the last slide. What is shown on the right hand side is a very good representation from this book by Stanley Middleman on Introduction to Fluid Dynamics, where only 9 components are shown, that is what we want. And what is shown? All the left side face, the bottom face and the rear face are shown, and all the forces are along the negative direction. Now, when we study, when we represent, we always like to represent or easy for understanding imagination if all of them are along the positive axis. That is why this representation is shown, where both the all the negative direction of forces and the positive direction of forces are shown. We require only either of them, either positive or negative. This representation is very sufficient, very much, but we are more comfortable looking at forces along the positive axis. That is why this representation is shown on the left hand side is shown, but the right hand side representation is very much sufficient. Okay.